चैप्टर नंबर 14 के प्रॉब्लम्स करेंगे. सबसे पहले प्रॉब्लम, राइट द वैल्यू ऑफ द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड दैट विल कॉज अ मैक्सिमम फोर्स ऑफ 7×10⁻³ न्यूटन ऑन अ 20 cm स्ट्रेट वायर कैरिंग अ करंट ऑफ 10 A. अब इसमें से मैक्सिमम फोर्स जो है दैट इज इट्स वैल्यू इज 7×10⁻³ न्यूटन और इसके बाद लेंथ दी भी है आपको 20 cm. इसको आप कन्वर्ट कर लेंगे इनटू मीटर सो दैट विल बी इक्वल टू 0.2 m. करंट वैल्यू इज 10 A. फाइंड करना है इसमें वैल्यू ऑफ द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. तो वैल्यू ऑफ द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड में हमें फॉर्मूला पता है दैट इज इक्वल टू एफ. अगर हम कंसीडर करते हैं फॉर द मैक्सिमम फोर्स F is equal to B, the magnetic field, I, the current, and L is the length. तो यहां से हम ये डिटर्मिन कर सकते हैं B की वैल्यू. रीअरेंज कर देते हैं, B is equal to F divided by I into L. ठीक, तो इसको सॉल्व करेंगे तो आपके पास मैग्नेटिक फील्ड की वैल्यू आ जाएगी. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 14.2, हाउ फास्ट मस्ट अ प्रोटॉन मूव इन अ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड ऑफ 2.5×10⁻³ टेस्ला सच दैट द मैग्नेटिक फोर्स इज इक्वल टू इट्स वेट. मैग्नेटिक फोर्स जो है इट शुड बी इक्वल टू इट्स वेट. लेट्स सी कि इसमें किस तरह से होगा. जी, मैग्नेटिक फोर्स दैट इज एफ इज इक्वल टू क्यू द चार्ज वी इज द वेलोसिटी इनटू द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. ये मैग्नेटिक फोर्स पे अब वो क्या कहते हैं कि इट शुड बी इक्वल टू इट्स वेट. अगर इसको वेक्टर फॉर्म से पहले कन्वर्ट कर लेते हैं, अगर कंसीडर कर रहे हैं इफ द मोशन ऑफ द प्रोटॉन इज पर एट मेकिंग अ राइट एंगल यानी उसके विद द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड देन द एंगल विल बी वी बी साइन थीटा विल बी इक्वल टू 90. तो फोर्स विल बी इक्वल टू क्यू वी बी. अब ये फोर्स this force is equal to the weight of the proton. A weight of the proton, it is also another form of force, जो कि due to the acceleration, due to gravity होती है. अब इसको equate कर देंगे, यानी q v b is equal to mg. यहां से आपने determine करना है the velocity of the proton moving in magnetic field will be mg divided by qb. From this formula aap isme se determine kar sakte hain velocity of the proton. Now next question, question number 3, a velocity selector has a magnetic field of 0.3 tesla. If a perpendicular electric field of 10,000 velocity per meter is applied, what will be the speed of the particle that will pass through the selector? अब इसमें दोनों तरह की fields apply हुई भी हैं, magnetic field भी है and electric field भी है. अगर जब दोनों तरह की field act कर रही हैं, तो charge जो है, वो किस velocity के साथ वो move करेगा, वो आपने determine करना है. In order to determine that, आपको फॉर्मूला डिराइव करना पड़ेगा. लेट्स सी, फॉर्मूला विल बी कि कंसीडर करें इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड फोर्स दैट इज इक्वल टू क्यू ई व्हाइल द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड फोर्स इज इक्वल टू क्यू वी बी. सो दीज आर द मैग्नीट्यूड्स ऑफ द टू फोर्सेस दैट इज फॉर द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एंड दैट इज फॉर द मैग्नेटिक फोर्स. इलेक्ट्रिक फोर्स एंड द मैग्नेटिक फोर्स इनको इक्वेट करेंगे, क्यू क्यू कैंसिल हो गया, ई विल बी इक्वल टू वी बी. From here you can determine the velocity or the speed of the particle that is present in electric and the magnetic field. If it is electric field is perpendicular, if there it is perpendicular, so we have taken the angle of 90 degree. Now V is equal to E divided by B. So by using this formula you can determine the speed of the particle which passes through the selector of the two fields. Now here comes the next question, question number 14.4. A coil of 0.1 meter into 0.1 meter and 200 turns carrying a current of 1 milliampere is placed in a uniform magnetic field of 0.1 tesla. Calculate the maximum torque that acts on the coil. First of all, we will determine the area of the coil. Area of the coil kitna se determine karenge, 0.1 into 0.1 inko multiply karenge. So the area of the coil will be 0.01 meter square. Number of turns is given, that is capital N is given over here. It is equal to 200. Current given in milliampere, isko convert kar lenge ampere mein. So 1 milliampere is equal to 1 into 10 raised to power minus 3 ampere. Magnetic field B ki value, that is strength of the magnetic field is given, that is equal to 0.1 tesla. Now you have to determine the torque. Torque to determine karne ke liye by using the formula. So formula for the torque is torque maximum, it is equal to B magnetic field, I the current, N is the number of turns, and area is the cross section area. So by using this formula you can determine the maximum torque that acts on the coil. Now the next question, question number 14.5. A power line 10 meter high carries a current 200 ampere. Find the magnetic field of the wire at the ground. Current is 200 ampere. Height of the power line, that is R. R is equal to 10 meter. R ki value 10 hai. And the permeability of the air, it is 4 pi into 10 raised to power minus 7. So by using the Ampere's law, you can determine the magnetic field value. Let's see how. First of all, the H, that is equal to R, its value is 10 meters. Current is 200 ampere. Mu naught value is for the permeability of air, that is 4 pi into 10 raised to power minus 7 Weber per meter ampere. Okay, so the magnetic field B is equal to, B is equal to, by using the Ampere's law, mu naught I divided by 2 pi R. So from here we can determine the strength of the magnetic field. Next question, question number 14.6. You are asked to design a solenoid that will give a magnetic field of 0.1 tesla. Yet the current must not exceed 10 ampere. Find the number of turns per unit length. That is n, small n. You have to determine the small n. Well, small n is your number of turns per unit length that the solenoid should have. So we have to design a solenoid that will give a magnetic field of 0.1 tesla. So again, by using the same formula of Ampere's law, you will determine it. So here we will consider the formula B is equal to mu naught, n is the number of terms I. So by putting that, rearranging it, B divided by mu naught I. So here you can determine the number of turns per unit length for a solenoid having a magnetic field strength of 0.1 tesla. Next question, question number 14.7. What current should pass through a solenoid that is 0.5 meter long with 10,000 turns of copper wire so that it will have a magnetic field of 0.4 tesla. So here, what is given? This is magnetic field, B's value. This is capital N value. And the length is 0.5 meters. So we have to determine what current passes through it. We will use the same formula as we used in the previous question. Here, we will use the formula. B is equal to mu naught N I. In question, we have been given capital N value that was equal to 10,000 turns with length of 0.5 meter. So we can determine number of turns per unit length, N divided by L. So B is equal to mu naught N I divided by L. By rearranging it, in order to determine the current, I is equal to B is equal to BL divided by mu naught N. BL divided by mu naught L. By using this formula, we can determine the value of the current that should pass through a solenoid. Question number 14.8. A galvanometer having an internal resistance RG that is 15 ohms gives full scale deflection with current IG that is equal to 20 milliampere, which is 20 into 10 raised to the power minus 3 ampere. It is to be converted into an ammeter of range 10 ampere. So the current I that is given, which is equal to 10 ampere, find the value of shunt resistance. So here we know the formula. By using that formula, we can determine the shunt resistance. The formula is, R S is the shunt resistance that is equal to IG, galvanometer current, galvanometer resistance into the galvanometer resistance divided by I, the current at which we want to convert the ammeter, the range of the current at which we want to make an ammeter or to convert galvanometer into ammeter. That is, we have used that its value is 10 ampere minus IG. So by using this formula, galvanometer current into galvanometer resistance divided by I minus IG, we can determine the shunt resistance. Next question, question number 14.9. the resistance of a galvanometer is 50 ohm and reads full scale deflection with a current of 2 milliampere, that is 2 into 10 raised to the power minus 3 ampere. Show by a diagram how to convert this galvanometer into voltmeter reading 200 volt full scale. So 200 meter full scale is given over here. The resistance of galvanometer, that is 50 ohm, is also given over here. And the current, full scale deflection current, IG, that is also given over here. It is equal to 2 into 10 raised to the power minus T. So by using the formula for determining the high resistance RH is equal to V, that the voltage to be measured, that is a full scale voltage, divided by IG current minus RG. So by using this formula, you can determine the resistance to, in order to convert the galvanometer into voltmeter. Now the last question, 14.10. The resistance of a galvanometer coil is 10 ohm and reads full scale with a current of 1 milliampere. So 10 ohm is RG's value, while 1 milliampere, that is 1 into 10 to the power minus 3 ampere, that is IG value. What should be the values of resistance R1, R2 and R3, which is shown over here in a figure, to convert this galvanometer into a multi-range ammeter of 100, that is 100, 10 and 1 ampere shown in figure. For here we consider, let's see, this one is 100 ampere, that is current 1. 10 ampere, we consider it current 2. And 1 ampere, it is current 3. So these are the three currents. So by using the same formula, that is for the shunt resistance, we can determine it. Let's see how. First of all, we know the formula. R is equal to IG, RG divided by I minus IG. So by using the same formula, we can determine the resistance R1, R2 and R3. For R1, it is equal to IG, RG divided by, the current will be I1 minus IG. So by using the formula, you can determine. For R2, it is IG, RG divided by I2 minus IG. Similarly, for R3, it is equal to IG, my RG divided by I3 minus IG. So these are the formulas from where you can determine the resistance R1, R2 and R3, and you know the value, as I have mentioned, over here, that I1 is 100 ampere, I2 is 10 ampere, I3 is 1 ampere. So by putting that values of current, you can determine the resistance R1, R2 and R3. So these were all the numericals of chapter number 14.